Entrepreneur is challenging America to a 60-second elevator ride to pitch the next billion-dollar idea to our board of successful investors.
I want to help, and I want to be a part of this.
You're going to need to raise a lot more money.
I think we're understating the pricing.
There's not a process in place to get to your end game.
If their pitch is successful.
That is great.
Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
But if their pitch fails.
Send them down.
Going down.
Going down.
The board has 5 minutes to make a deal, and you, the viewer, can support your favorite entrepreneur through crowdfunding. This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Going up.
I'm ready to make some money. How about you?
Ready. I'm ready to be inspired.
Right. Inspired? I want money.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hey everybody, my name is Ray Dustar and I'm the CEO and founder of this guy, Boost Liquid Multivitamin. So let's start with the why. Why did I create this? Because I hated swallowing pill form vitamins and I got very nauseous from that process. So instead of choking down pills every day, I wanted a better solution. There's 150 million Americans right now that are taking a multivitamin in pill form every day. There's 150 million that are not. And the reason they're not taking it is because they don't like to swallow pills and they get nauseous as well. So instead, we're gonna drink our vitamins every morning. This product is gluten-free, GMO-free, dairy, nut, and soy-free, so it's totally allergen-free, so it's great for the kids as well. No artificial preservatives, no artificial flavors, no artificial colors, no artificial sweeteners. So this product is a product that will disrupt the vitamin industry and give people a better solution on a daily basis.
Three,
that's it. Join me. I want to be part of this.
Well, I like things that disrupt.
I agree.
I don't know what the market is for it. I mean, I need to learn more about it.
I thought that was one of the best pitches I've seen. I want to learn more, and that's the objective of opening the doors, but I thought it was terrific. I'd love to open the doors.
I agree.
It's okay.
Yeah, I'd love to open the door, too.
Bring them in.
All right, open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hallelujah! Hey, now that's what I'm talking about.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hey, good to be here, guys.
Hey,
thanks for letting me come up. What I'm laying out for you right now, this is the daily multivitamin. That bottle is 30 ounces, so there's a full 1 month supply in there. That cap is a 1 ounce cap, and that delivers 100% daily value of this entire spectrum of vitamins A through K.
Okay.
I want to know about the money and the business of it.
I'll tell you, you've never been in business with a guy like me before. Because I'm
counting on that.
First of all, I've built a scalable business, okay? I use all contract manufacturers. My overhead is zero.
Is the company just you, or do you have other people?
Company's just me. For the past 3 years, I've focused on selling all off my website and then building an Amazon business. I'm doing about 20 to 50 grand a month online right now.
How much money did you make last year? I assume whatever.
300 to 400, right?
Yeah, 300 to 400. Yeah, you know, profited about
profit,
200, yeah.
Profit about 200.
Yeah, yeah. One piece of very exciting news. I just got back from the Made in the USA Summit at Walmart. I got approved for Walmart.com. But I also did get tentatively approved for the store.
What percentage of your company would you like to partner with us for?
You know, I'd like for initially to partner at maybe, let's say, maybe $100,000 seed round at a 5% equity stake to do a $2 million valuation.
Not bad.
I have two questions. What's the $100,000 gonna really be used for? And more importantly, when we ask the question, it was an interesting answer. It was almost like nonchalant, casual.
Yeah.
It was just like, hey, you know, maybe we could do some money, maybe 100,000, maybe 100,000, maybe 5%. It was sort of weird that it was like you were almost winging it on the spot. Had you thought through this? Or were you just literally picking that number right then and there out of thin air?
No, I've thought through it, but here's the thing. I'm not here for your money. What I need is, I need Rainmaker from a connection standpoint. I need doors opened up. To be honest, what the hell am I gonna do with 100,000? Probably not that much. It'll hopefully fund the first Walmart PO from a manufacturing standpoint.
The 100,000 is not the issue. I would say 20% of the company for the 100,000, and then you have four people to be working with you to help drive social influencing, to drive retail distribution, to drive all the different things necessary to make this successful.
Yeah, yeah.
That would at least be where my head is sort of in.
I don't disagree.
I concur.
20%, 100,000.
Yes, I love it.
You got
it.
A deal?
Let's do it. Let's do it.
All right.
Sounds good. Sounds good.
And you can be the spokesperson.
I gotta be the spokesperson. Yeah. Thanks, guys. I really appreciate it.
Nice to meet you.
Looking forward to working with you guys.
Looking forward to working with you
Absolutely.
As well.
Absolutely. And remember, one cap full every morning, okay?
Got it.
Start your
day.
Talk
to you soon, Ray.
What I saw in the four of them collectively was a desire to help take this to the next level. And that's what I'm looking for more than money.
To support this entrepreneur, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, I'm Barbara Giannetti, owner and founder of DeGiulia Pasta Sauce. You're probably thinking, does the world need another pasta sauce? And the answer is yes, they need mine. My pasta sauces are all natural, they're gluten and GMO free, they're 100% clean and made with 100% pure Italian imported tomatoes. And they're also delicious. I grew up in a family where we ate pasta almost every day. My parents were born in Italy, and dinner time was super, super important tradition to us. And when I got married, I wanted to continue the same tradition with my family. However, I worked full time, and I didn't have time to come home and make a sauce from scratch. Therefore, I tried sauces on the market, didn't like any of them, and decided to develop my own. So these are all my family recipes. This is my dad. He's my guardian angel. I have pictures of my family on my labels. I'm seeking $50,000 for 20% equity in my company, and I need distribution money for trade shows, BOGOs, and free fills. I need to get in the store shelves. If I get in the store shelves, I will get my pasta sauce to the shelf because the best sauce is on the market.
$50,000 for 20% of the company to try to get her to for distribution, then we have to spend millions to compete.
Yeah, that's such a competitive market. Yeah.
Put it this way, if that was the best spaghetti sauce you've ever tasted, would you invest in that at this level right now?
It still would be almost an impossible journey.
That's what's going through my mind.
I won't do it, I'm out.
For the betterment of her, I would send her down.
Let's send her down.
Going down.
Bummer. That's not great when they go going down. Not a great sound.
Oh, they finally got that in there. How are they gonna get it out?
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, I'm Karen. This is Chris. We're the founders of Design Your Own Bed, and we sell comfort. I've been in the mattress manufacturing business my whole entire life, and to this day, there is no mattress that totally takes care of pain and pressure management. So, 80% of all Americans will have back pain in their life. That's roughly 250 million people that are looking for a solution to their musculoskeletal health. So what if you had that solution? Well, we do.
Right.
Meet me. Me is the world's greatest mattress that you will ever sleep on. It's the industry's first total body pressure management system. It is modular, which means that it won't fill up landfills because 50,000 mattresses are discarded every day.
So all you do is
take out pieces if you need to replace them.
Time's up.
They're gonna have to make a compelling scenario because this is one of the most crowded spaces of all.
It's very crowded, it's very competitive. I'm curious to hear what her background is. Her whole life, professional life, she's been in the mattress industry, so I mean, that's important. I think we should open the door.
Let's open up the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Woo!
All right. Welcome to the boardroom.
Okay.
I can hold it right here.
60 floors, that came up.
So, this is our me bed.
So did you guys design this?
This is completely our design.
You said your background is in the mattress industry?
It is. I was weaned in it, I mean, since I was a baby. I think I was babysat at the factory.
But I'm guessing that's a real working prototype. Who would ever buy a mattress without at least laying on it first? So why would I invest in a mattress company without at least seeing what the product is? Is that something that could be laid on right now?
You can lay on it, but...
One standard comfort, so I didn't really...
It's fine. It was for convenience.
And I don't need to have to cuddle with Dave or whatever.
But we have a topper. I'd have to go back down to go get the topper to really... But you can lay on this.
Let's do it.
Yeah, this is our very first, like, dimensional prototype.
Okay.
You can see how the actual pieces.
So you could change this right here.
No, I got a feel. Thank you.
Okay.
So what are you looking for?
We think it's a multi-million-dollar idea, and what we'd like to do is ask for $200,000 for 20% of the business.
We have a personal testimonial here, so I think we need to hear first from Peter.
I want to try to be as respectful as possible.
I understand. Okay.
And I know it didn't have the topper and all the other stuff on it. I hated the experience. I don't even know what to say. It felt like I was on some, like, egg carton.
Well, that's most important feedback that we could get.
We have to pass. Oh, wow. I don't think it's quite ready.
It's great for the opportunity.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very
best
much.
Best of luck.
It was a prototype. If I had the real one, they would have loved it.
To support this entrepreneur, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins
now. Here
we now.
Go.
Doing up.
Hi, my name is Mike Bradford. I'm from Pflugerville, Texas, and this is the Wonderful Stuff Waffle Iron. The Wonderful Stuff Waffle Iron makes a meal in a waffle. It's a patent-pending cooking device that allows you to make any meal portable by fully enclosing it in a Belgian-style waffle. Now, people love to eat on the go, but you can't do that with regular waffles because they're just too unwieldy or messy. But the Wonderful Stuff Waffle Iron has sufficient volume and size to allow you to put anything in your waffle, including fried chicken or bacon and eggs, cheese, whatever you want to have.
Sounds really good.
This is more than a waffle maker. It's a creative canvas on which cooks can explore their culinary ideas. I want to see these waffles eaten in restaurants, in hotels, in fast food joints, and at homes. Speaking of which, I've got 3 kids at home, and you know what? If you want to get them to eat their veggies, put them in a stuffed waffle. I want your investment so that we can open the doors to this new culinary idea.
That is great.
He is so likable.
He is likable.
The product's clever.
Yeah. The product is clever.
You know the business.
Well, yeah, I know the business, and you know there's a market for it somewhere, and I would definitely like to hear what he has to say.
He said to us that his product is going to open the doors to waffles. We should open the doors for him.
Right, great. Let's open the doors.
Let's do
Welcome
it.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Yes.
You did great in there.
Welcome, Mike. Thanks, Welcome to the boardroom.
You have such good energy.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Everybody loves to eat.
Yeah.
So I do think that this is a great product with potential. Mm-hmm. What does something like this sell for?
Right now, we're taking pre-orders, and they're selling for $99.
And what's your cost?
My cost to manufacture is $29, and so my full profit margin is about 65%.
$29.99.
And where are you in the company? Do you have just the prototype and you have some pre-orders? Have you actually sold some of these things?
We are in late stage manufacture, so all of our orders have been pre-ordered so far.
So you haven't sold any yet?
I haven't sold any physical device yet, no.
So do you have a patent on it?
It's patent pending.
Have you spoken to any retailers like a Williams-Sonoma or?
I have not spoken with any retailers yet. I mean, this is my only unit. Unfortunately, I'm not at that position yet where I can really negotiate or speak truthfully with a retailer.
You still have a full-time job.
I still have a full-time job. I'm a software developer.
How far do you think he can take this before you have to make a decision about your full-time job?
Well, it just really depends on funding. I can't quit right now. My wife's pregnant with our fourth child, and you know, so I'm just,
thank
you. Yeah, you know, so I can't leave my day job right now just yet.
We'll talk about numbers?
Yeah, numbers. Yeah.
What are you looking for?
So I'm looking for $100,000 because I need to finish the pilot run, and I need a lot of dollars for marketing because I've done really none right now. I'm willing to negotiate 10% of royalties in the sale of this waffle iron.
The valuation makes it really, really difficult to figure out when it's 10% royalties on profit when you don't really even know if it's protectable, profitable.
It feels a little premature to me.
Yeah.
It feels like you've got something, but it hasn't evolved to where it's supposed to go yet. You've got the product, but there's not a process in place to get to your end game.
My personal suggestion would be you got a lot in the hopper.
Right.
Let even if you're making progress every month, even a few months go by, utilize Indiegogo, get some higher revenue in so that everyone has a comfort level to say, wow, that's worth 15 or 20%.
Okay.
Yeah, and I think what you're hearing from all of us is, you know, very interested in you, very interested in the concept, and want to be supportive, but also want to have a better sense of where this business model is going.
We might be doing you a favor, because now you're going to have something that is more tangible, you're going to have something that's more definitive, so when you do go out and try to scale it to the next level, you'll be in a position of strength. Use this ability that you have. Look at the smile.
Exactly, this charisma.
It's the charisma.
I wanted to invest in you, I really did.
Yeah.
And use that to your advantage.
Well, I really appreciate your time, and thank you for the advice. You know, I'm going to keep working hard.
Thank you so much.
Thanks,
thank
Mike.
You guys.
Really nice to meet you.
Thank you.
We'll see you soon.
Thank you, guys.
All right, bye.
To support this entrepreneur, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.
They want to see how things go. They want to see how sales go. They want to see how my product works with Indiegogo customers and just, you know, take it from there.
Next on Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
This is at least a $3 billion market.
There is no revenue.
What?
Each entrepreneur who appears on Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch can be followed live at entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch. To apply for season 2, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.